Bill Gates is the quintessential entrepreneur, living his passion with dedication, hard work, and strong business sense. He is an American business magnate, investor, computer programmer, inventor, and philanthropist. Born in Seattle, United States in 1955, Bill had shown a huge interest in computer programming since the age of 13 at Lakeside School, where he met his friend and business partner, Paul Allen, and with whom he built the world's largest software business, Microsoft. Both Bill and Paul worked for Honeywell before they took on a project with MITS, the maker of Altair Computer, and formed a partnership called Microsoft, a blend of microcomputer and software. Bill's ability to come up with the right technology at the right time made Microsoft a leader in the computer software industry. And Microsoft's operating system Windows still dominates until now, partly through Bill Gates' ingenuity and aggressive business tactics. After decades of running a corporation, in 2006, Bill announced his plan to transition from full-time work at Microsoft to devote more time for Bill and his wife Melinda Gates Foundation. On June the 27th, 2008, he spent his last full day work at Microsoft. Finally, in February this year, Bill stepped down as chairman of Microsoft to a new position as technical advisor.
Which reminds me, I remember interviewing you a few years ago, and you were then still running Microsoft. Now, how did the transition from being an entrepreneur into philanthropy come about? Was it sort of a long process, or perhaps you could share with us?
Well, I loved my work at Microsoft, and I'm still an advisor there. But you know, I chose that I thought younger people should be running the company. And so it was 6 years ago now that I ended my full-time work there and switched over to the foundation. I'm lucky that the kinds of things I learned at Microsoft about being very numerical, very
IT
market-driven, and believing in science, you know, picking good science projects. Now it's more biology than software. Mm-hmm. But it's the same type of thing, betting on innovation that can make a big difference. And so that kind of private sector, science-based mindset mm-hmm. has been helpful to me in the foundation. And we've assembled very strong teams. We've gotten smarter over time. Mm-hmm. And so for me, it's as enjoyable as the Microsoft work is. And it's something that we'll all get to do in partnership with my wife for the rest of my life.
Mm-hmm. And in terms of the philosophy behind it, is there some kind of philosophy behind the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation?
Well, the basic principle is that all lives have equal value. And so it's very strange that children are allowed to die, millions, because they don't get the medicines that children in rich countries have aren't properly distributed to every country of the world. And so believing in that equity principle, we've picked global health as our primary area of activity. And you know, we've learned how impactful this can be. Not only do you save millions of lives, but the kids who survive have better nutrition, better health, their brain develops fully, their body, and they're able to achieve their full potential. We should spend as much helping those people as we do people in the United States.
Mm-hmm. And polio is one of the diseases that you're quite passionate about. Tell me a little bit about it.
Well, I'm biased. I spend more time on polio than anything else. And
is there any particular reason why it's?
It's a disease we're in the process of eradicating. And so by getting to zero, no child will ever be paralyzed again. And when this campaign started, 400,000 children a year were being crippled by polio. Mm-hmm. We're down to very few cases. We have less than 400 cases a year, and it's just three countries that we haven't gotten rid of it: Nigeria, Pakistan, mm-hmm. and Afghanistan. And those are difficult places to reach all the children You've got violence there, some of it actually targeted, very surprisingly, at polio itself. And so we're going to have to do a great job, but it'll become only the second disease after smallpox over 40 years ago, the second disease to be completely eradicated.
Guided by the belief that every life has equal value, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation works to help all people lead healthy, productive lives. Founded in 1997, the foundation was named as the William H. Gates Foundation before renamed as the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation after a merger with the Gates Learning Foundation in 2000. In 2006, the foundation received 10 million Berkshire Hathaway shares from Warren Buffett, CEO and largest shareholder of the company, with a donation to be given over multiple years through annual contributions. Warren Buffett became one of the trustees of the foundation, together with Bill and Melinda Gates. It was also the year Bill Gates announced his plans to transition out a full-time role in Microsoft to devote more time working with the foundation. Through their programs that combined researches and advances in science and technology, the foundation has discovered breakthrough solutions that are affordable in the forms of vaccines, drugs, and diagnoses to help prevent and eradicate the world's major infectious diseases, including HIV, polio, tuberculosis, and malaria. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation also works through and with partners across the world, such as the Global Fund, dedicated to tackling AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria in developing countries. This global fund will also work and guide the Indonesia Health Fund to properly achieve its objectives. I talked to Christoph Ben, director of the Global Fund, on how important the fund's role is in improving health and to make sure the Indonesia Health Fund works effectively.
And what would you like to see coming out of this health fund? Any specific targets or wish list that needs to sort of be implemented or achieved by a certain date? Or?
Sure. I mean, what we are trying to do here is to support health programs in Indonesia. The Global Fund has been a partner with Indonesia for more than 10 years. We've invested more than $400 million mm-hmm. already in Indonesia on AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria. We're working closely with the Ministry of Health under the leadership of Dr. Mboy. Mm-hmm. But what we see now is that, private businessmen from the country are also supporting that. So mm-hmm. we are putting together the domestic funding in Indonesia with the support then of the Global Fund, which represents the money of the international community from many governments mm-hmm. around the world, and now also the private sector coming together, philanthropists putting in the money. That will help us to really close the gap to finance mm-hmm. universal access to services for all these diseases. So that's a very important step indeed.
Mm, how much money are we talking about here? There's the initial investment of the Indonesia Health Fund itself.
Dr. Tahir himself made $65 million available already last year. And now he has asked his friends and, mm-hmm. and other business leaders to step up and provide more funding. The target is to have an additional $100 million from the business community here in Indonesia. So that is a fantastic target, I think, and will help many, many people here in Indonesia.